Carter and Jesse Donaldson emigrated to Cincinnati in Ohio and ran safe houses for runaway slaves on the Ohio Riverbank. Writing songs in Cincinnati at the time, at the same time during the 1840s and 1850s, was Stephen Collins Foster, sometimes called the father of American music. This, our first song, is a popular song that Jesse and Anna would have heard at the time. It might be a little different from the version you've heard on karaoke machines.
From Fisk University, Nashville, Tennessee, arrived in Swansea in 1874 on a fundraising tour for their campus buildings. They sang at Swansea Music Hall in Craddock Street, the old Albert Hall, and women with babies in arms were welcomed into the concerts. This is one of their slave songs.
Thank you.
Jesse's was the third. Stephen Collins Foster watched the working lives and heard the work songs coming across the river, and he was sympathetic to the anti-slavery cause. Music was his way of telling their stories and the plight of the runaways. Paul Robeson recorded this next song in his Plantation Melody.
Which won the Diversity Wales Award in 2003. The next song became the signature tune of Louis Armstrong, written in 1931 by Clarence Mews. It depicts the migration of African Americans from the South to cities of the North. It was also recorded by Paul Robeson on his LP Plantation Medley. Sleepy Time Down South. Thank you.
Songbook written in 1883 by Clare and Andrews. It was performed in our school's production before Freedom in order to get the children up, paddling and singing to get our runaway slave Willis across the mighty Ohio River to his freedom. So if you'd like to get up and join in, you can do some paddling action yourselves.
Jessie Donaldson, I mean, what a remarkable story that is, came back home to Swansea after the end of the American Civil War in 1865. African Americans thought they had been freed. The next song is traditional, but set to Joshua fit the Battle of Jericho.
Pray out in the valley, pray chain down. Broke at last, broke at last, broke at last. Slavery chain down. Broke at last. Gonna praise God till I die.
Witnessed the first jazz age in Swansea when women producers, directors, musicians and dancers were running the cafes set up during the First World War. The smallest cafe seated 400, the largest 1,000. They thrived and many African American orchestras, combos and revue shows were hired to perform for them on the afternoon floor shows. Ma Rainey sadly didn't come, but we wish she had. She had a huge hit with this 1927 number, and believe me, it still goes down well today.
Yeah.
too short a gig. Apparently you're on to our last number already. It has just been a snapshot. Our last song is one of our signature tunes. It was written in the 1940s by the great Nat King Cole. And we hope you've enjoyed our little dip into the archives. And if you'd like to know more about us, or book us for a gig, then you may. Oh, Diva may talk.
We do go out as the Three Divas. And as you always say, we're available for
weddings, bar mitzvahs, funerals, divorce parties, children's parties.
She does that stuff really well. I'm not so good at it. But I
street
do
parties.
Want to say that Jazz Heritage Wales has given so many women opportunities to make music and to launch little bands. And it's just been a wonderful journey. And thank you so much to Gail Allen, who's our treasurer and who is unstinting support. And again to Deb Checkland as well. And all of the other women, Silva and Gabriel, Derek Gabriel, who's not a woman, but who has been so generous with his time and dedication to Jazz Heritage Wales. Thank you all. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.
Welcome back.
Straight to you, I'm an errand girl forever. Send me. You can always find me down at
Smokey Joe's.
Oh, that's where all the smart and swinging people go. Sha-da-da. If you want variety, take a tip and call on me. I'm an errand girl forever.
Just call me if you want to swing and shout. She's the gal to